How's it going, everyone? Welcome to Double Pebble, and this week is our first icon review video. I can only review players that I get, so I happen to be able to buy icon, and the first one that I got was Rivaldo, icon Rivaldo, which is who we are going to be looking at today. I remember when I came up against this guy, he was crazy, like scoring goals for fun against me. So it was quite interesting for me to try him out. Alright, as usual, first thing we need to look at his stats first. Well, being an icon, right, you are expecting his stats to be insane. And honestly, it is truly, truly remarkable. It is definitely miles better than normal players. So we look at his height first, 186, 75 kg, the kind of build that I like. But I'm concerned about his weak foot because his right foot is only 2 rated. 4 stars, and FP for icon FP is such a major factor because they are so expensive. When it comes to FP cost, he is 25, and his stats in general is basically quite insane. Every single important stat is above 100. 105 sprint, 103 acceleration, agility is crazy, dribbling, ball control, crossing, short passing, finishing, long shot, every single thing is above 100. And they've got positioning as well, vision is there, reaction, shot power, volley, penalties, long passing, free kicks is 109 for some reason, and then his shot curve is 111, and balance is a little bit low but still 94. I've seen him play a little when I was a kid, but I don't ever remember him being good with his kit like most Brazilians. 93 heading, and then strength is 98. Stamina is 102, aggression obviously lower, but jump is 92 as well, composure is 108. Work rate is also something that I'm concerned about, low mid, which is definitely nowhere near the ideal work rate. If you look at the hexagon, everything is over the limit already. A lot of traits as well, diver, that can come in handy when he's in the box. Prefer main feed, a big problem actually. Prefer individual play, this one for manager mode, but it's got a sharp curling shot, this one very important. Impressive skill, also important. Long shots for AI, finesse, free kick. Price wise, obvious lah, he is an icon. Icon has a premium, 1.2 billion. One of the more expensive icon, I believe. If we take a look at all the icon price, the most expensive two is obviously Eusebio and Johan Cruyff. And then after that, we have Steven Gerrard, and then we have Baggio and Rivaldo already. So they are around the mid-range for icon, alright? And the main thing is actually the FP cost. 25 is very, very hefty, alright? Now we go into the in-game analysis, and you will be surprised with what I have to say. Like I said, being an icon, he basically has insane stats, and honestly speaking, if you were to analyze his stats, it's no day no night one. So I will just point out a few things that stands out to me. Okay, first thing is pace. Icons are all insanely fast, and that includes Rivaldo. He is so fast that many times, right, once he commits to the left or right and the defender makes a mistake or take a little bit more time to react, right, he is gone already. I've seen that so many times. One-on-one with the defender hit on, he just goes to the left, and then if the defender choose to go to the right or just stands him off for a split second, because of that crazy high acceleration, it's impossible to catch him once. So pace is actually one of his biggest strengths. And the next thing is his movement. Now Rivaldo definitely has the samba flair to him. He's very silky smooth on the ball. If you look at the stats again, ball control, dribbling, agility, balance, everything is very, very high. So if you try to manipulate and move around on the pitch with him, right, is a breeze actually. Another thing that I noted is, and this is something that I've never said before, is his crossing ability. He is such a great crosser, and that is even before the latest gameplay update whereby the crossing will have a lot of whip on it. This is before that, and he is already a great crosser. Look at the highlights and you can see how many times he crossed beautifully for the attacker to hit. And the good thing about him is I find that most of his crosses don't go near the goalkeeper, so the keeper has no chance to come out. That is so important in FO4 because the goalkeepers are so active in this game. And the next thing that I noticed is, of course, physicality. He is very strong, alright? He's able to take damage from defenders or midfielders, definitely. But then again, I feel the game is quite fair in the sense that they are overpowered but not to an unrealistic extent. then I still see Rivaldo get butched away by someone like Virgil van Dijk because of the fact that van Dijk has a heavier body weight. So that is still logical, but in general, Rivaldo is very, very tanky and finishing is great, although there is a caveat because his left foot is magical. Very, very good finishing with his left foot, as you guys can see in the highlights. Whatever he touched with his left foot most of the time goes into the back of the net, and he is able to score all kinds of goals with his left foot. His shot power is also insane. Again, if you refer to the highlights, there were many times where the goalkeeper don't even get a chance to react to the shot, such is the power of the shot. Long shot is crazy as well. Finesse shot with his left foot or normal shot with his left foot are all very, very good. Which will bring me to the next point, which is the weakness, and that is his right foot. That right foot of his is next to useless, honestly. It is very, very unreliable, and it is so bad that I start to consciously try to control the ball onto his left foot so that he can shoot, because I find that whenever he shoots with his right foot, it's very unpredictable. Sometimes it goes into the top corner, sometimes it goes to the corner flag. It's very, very bad. Of course, I think he scored a crazy finesse shot with his right foot once for me as well. So it's very unpredictable. That is his biggest problem. Another thing is his work rate. Now, this one depends on where you use him. I feel that for low mid, right, when I put him on the wings, he doesn't stretch the play as much as compared to a player with high mid work rate. So he tends to drop deep a lot more, and that really compacts the field. I can't really switch the play, I can't really stretch the play to open up the field when I attack. And it's so congested in the final attacking third that I find it very hard to play. But if you use him as a striker, I feel that it is still okay. It's almost like GR Rooney. Attacking work rate low is still okay for striker, but on the wings, I feel that that is the biggest problem. Alright, overall, I'll give him an 8.5 out of 10. I think this one might surprise some people because Icon, you're expecting 10-10. But there is just two big weaknesses that really knocks him off, and that is the weak foot and his work rate. I personally feel that he performs better as a striker because the work rate issue is not that great, but that weak foot of his really makes him not as reliable a player. And against stronger opponent, I find that he does get found out when he's in a striker position. But being an icon, he is still very, very good, and he will definitely score you goals if you choose to use him. It's just that I feel that he is not an easy player to use. You need to be relatively good at this game in order to utilize him well. Is he worth it? To be honest, 1.2 billion is a lot of money, and it will take you quite a long time to save up if you can even have the patience to reach that value. His price is partly also because of his stats and the fact that he has the Icon Premier. I personally, right, wouldn't recommend him, to be honest, because of the fact that he has a very bad weak foot and work rate, and against strong opponents who presses you incessantly, it is even harder to always have to manipulate the ball to his left foot. And that is the reason why I actually sold him off to buy another icon instead. So, and that is all I have for this review, our first icon review video. I hope you guys find it entertaining. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy my review video. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell for more videos. Check out our Facebook and Discord as well. The links are all in the description box, and I'll see you next time.